Is the Apple ID account on iOS more secure than the Gmail account on Android? They take dissimilar approaches to account security. We'll explain the differences and help you decide. Hello, everyone. This is Rick with Cybermedics. The Apple ID on the iPhone is analogous to the Gmail account on your Android phone. These accounts are your first line of defense from hackers stealing data linked to your phone account. We'll demonstrate security best practices for account protection and detail how each company measures up. Before we get into the specifics of how each company handles account security, we're going to cover a little bit of background on account security, specifically second-factor authentication. Second-factor authentication is something you know, like a PIN or a password, plus something that you have, maybe like a security key or an authentication app, or something you are, a retina scan, facial scan, or fingerprint. Next, we're going to cover account best practices, starting with a strong password and a password manager. Many people write their passwords down and store them in a secure location. We strongly recommend using a password manager similar to Bitwarden, where you can manage those passwords. Also, you can generate strong passwords using the application itself. You can also secure the password manager with a security key. If you're not comfortable with putting all of your passwords in a single location, you can do something called a double blind password. We have a video linked above. We also have links to the videos on Bitwarden so that you can get started. Next, we'll cover the second factor authentication methods, what I consider pure second factor methods. First one is biometrics, which is something you are, a retina scan, facial scan, or a fingerprint. Next is the authentication application, which is something that generates one-time codes that typically are refreshed every 30 seconds, and then you would enter these codes to authenticate to your account. Locally generated codes are something that are generated by an app but doesn't require an internet connection or a cell connection. These are generated here, the ones you see displayed, by Gmail so that you can have a secure code and enter that to authenticate the account. Next are locally stored backup codes. Almost every account that you create gives you the opportunity to create a backup code. If you print these out or secure these in an encrypted file, you could always have these locally available in case you needed to authenticate with the codes. And finally, the hardware security key, which can be physically plugged in to a device, or it can use near-field communication to electronically communicate so that it can authenticate with the key. If you're not familiar with hardware security keys, we have a link to the videos that we have done on this topic. Next, we're going to cover what I consider gray second-factor authentication, not pure, in the sense that it is not something you have, it's something that is sent to you. Now, the problem I have with something sent to you is anything that's sent can be intercepted, manipulated, commandeered. This is one of the least secure methods of second-factor authentication. The other problem with this is a lot of people link their cell phones to their one device, they lose the device, and now they can no longer authenticate to their account. A more secure messaging method would be using Google Voice, although it still is requiring it to be transmitted, although it's more secure than your cellular text SMS messages. And the last one is push-based notifications. This is where you are signed into a device and Google will send a notification to that device and you can confirm that it is you and you can log in. But it does require a network connection in order for it to work properly. Now that we've covered second-factor authentication and recommended the best methods for second-factor authentication, we're going to compare head-to-head the Apple iPhone with the Android phone. When you log into an iPhone, you use something called an Apple ID. When you log into an Android phone, you use a Gmail account. So we're going to compare the security on both of these. The first one is biometrics, and they both support biometrics, facial scan and fingerprint, although Apple has pretty much phased out fingerprint readers on their newer phones. Google, on the other hand, supports fingerprint readers, so these both get a plus as far as supporting biometrics. The next one we're going to consider is the hardware security key. This is probably the best method for locking down an account and preventing hackers from getting access to your credentials. Unfortunately, Apple ID does not support this. It's only supported on the Android operating system. Next is an authentication app. The authentication app is linked to an account, and once you link that authentication app, it will generate a one-time passcode, usually a six-digit code that's regenerated approximately every 30 seconds. This number can be keyed in to authenticate to the particular device. It is not supported for authentication on the iPhone. Next are one-time codes that can be locally generated without the need for internet connection or cell connection. These one-time codes are generated and can authenticate you to your device. They are not supported on the Apple system, only on the Android system. Next are backup codes. When you implement second-factor authentication on the Gmail account tied to your phone, you are given the option to generate backup codes, highly recommended. These can function as a password in case you get locked out of your account and forgot your password. There is something similar on the Apple iOS. It's called a recovery key. Unfortunately, it's kind of buried. Even though you've turned on second-factor authentication, you have to really search for recovery key in order to be able to generate it. But once you've generated this recovery key, if you put it in a safe location, if you ever lost your password and couldn't authenticate to your device, you could use this recovery key to recover your account. So they both support a backup code. And finally, how do they stack up head-to-head? Well, here's biometrics, authentication app, locally generated codes, locally stored backup codes, and the hardware key. As you can see, there's better security options on the Gmail for your phone authentication than there is on your Apple ID for your iOS phone. Only two of the three biometrics and stored backup code are supported on the iPhone. Now that we've completed the head-to-head comparison of the Apple ID to the Android Gmail account security, I thought it would be useful to drill down into the security settings on each device separately. So over here on the iPhone, the way you do that is you go into settings, click on your account ID, come down to password and security, and here you see two-factor authentication is turned on. You have a phone number. This is a VoIP number. It is not a cell phone number. Please do not put your cell phone number on your single device secured to your account so that if you lose your device, you've lost your account access. It's happening to people all around the world. Account recovery is here. And this is where I was telling you have to drill down in order to get a backup recovery code from Apple. So once you select that, you come into recovery key. You can see it's off. Select that and then turn it on. Here it's warning you that you will now be in control and responsible for your data, which I highly recommend. Select Use Recovery Key. Once you authenticate to the phone, it will generate the recovery key. Now, there's some additional steps to that. We'll come over to the Android device, and we'll show you how to get into account security settings on it. Through the Android device, you go in through the Gmail account. Once you open account settings for the Gmail account on the device, you click the security tab. And then under security, down here at the bottom, you will see two-step verification. You can select that. Again, here on the iPhone, we have a phone number. And if you drill down, you get account recovery. And it's also a trusted device. Here we have hardware security key. We have Google Prompts, which is basically a trusted device. You have authentication app. You also have a voice, and you have backup codes. I think Apple purposely insulates people from detailed security settings so that they can reach back out to Apple for support in case they lose their password or have lost their device. Even if you reach out to Apple, there's no guarantee that you will get your data or your access to your devices again. Hope you will hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. This supports our efforts in helping others with technology. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below, and have a great and wonderful automation day.